In this video, we're talking about seven-step marketing ideas for small businesses or any type of business, really. Okay, stay tuned. All right. So I have a question that came in here, and I wanted to do a more generic video from the seven marketing idea series, seven-step marketing idea series. But this one is, I'm going to be generic in this. I'm not going to be specific on the business, on any type of business, but just understand that these concepts I'm sharing with you is applicable in any type of business, okay? I'm gonna advise you, once you're done with this video, make sure you go through the link that you see on the screen and download all the PDFs and all the stuff that comes with it, because it will explain exactly how this works step by step. But listen to me first and watch this video up to 10 to 15 times, because you're gonna grab some really good concept that an average business owner would not apply in the business, and that's why a lot of businesses are failing. So the question goes, 95% of all small businesses are expected to crash in their first 5 years. That's a well-known statistics, right? I'm suspecting that this is due to multiple different reasons that may include money management, strategy, marketing, but probably not limited to this list. Absolutely not limited to that list. But marketing is a big deal. Marketing is a big deal. It's a big part of it. Sometimes something tells me that marketing and generating consistent business is very high on that list. Is it? Yes, absolutely. Please share your thoughts. Thanks. All right. So this video is going to serve as a core concept video on this channel. And this is a video that you want to put in your playlist and you want to come back to it over and over again. And I will always refer people back to this video as well as a core when it comes to building a business of any type, okay? I don't care what the size of the business is. The concept I'm going to share with you here, I can wrap them all into, it's one of two different words, okay? And that's leverage and empire, okay? Empire, leverage. You know, you want to build an empire, that means you're thinking beyond one human being. You're thinking beyond what one human being can do in a lifetime, okay? And the only way to do that is you want to leverage other people's resources. So the second word that comes to me when I'm saying this is leverage, okay? Because, you know, being a superhuman is not going to work. Being a superman is not going to work, because you're not, okay? So you got to use some knowledge, of course, but everybody has knowledge. The part that most people don't have is wisdom, okay? Some wisdom. So we got to use some wisdom. Some ancient wisdom. If you read enough, you would have seen some of these things in certain places. So I'm going to share with you more. Hopefully it's a reminder, but if it's new to you, absolutely, I want you to feel free to soak it in and download everything in that link so you can use it in your business, okay? And what I'm about to share with you comes down to four different segments, and that's the three P's. The three P's is kind of identical to 3M, but they're a little bit different, okay? The 3 M's is a little bit more to the marketing side. The 3 P's is more as a business as a whole. And then I'm gonna share the 3 C's with you, which is essentially me breaking down one of the P's into processes that is gonna help you build your business in a more leveraged manner, okay? In a way that's sustainable, in a way that it doesn't matter what generation you wake up into, you can use this over and over again. It could be the generation of TV, radio, internet, right? Clearly we're in the internet age right now, but maybe this video 50 years from now is transcribed into something else entirely that's not the internet, right? Either way, these concepts are evergreen and they will always be evergreen. So that's what I'm going to share with you. So the first three steps in the seven steps marketing ideas for small business that we share here is, the first three steps is called the 3 P's, okay? And 3 P's is something I learned from the show CNBC, The Profit with Marcus. I'm not sure if that's where I learned it from, but they use it over there as well. But it's a concept that works, okay? And the 3 P's represent the product. You have a product you're selling, but a lot of people, that they're creating their product first before they identify the second P, which is people. So this day's and age, in this time and age, I tell you to flip it. Identify the people first, okay? Identify the people first, okay? Let me tell you right now. Identify the person you want to serve first, okay? And find out what they want, okay? Find out what they want. Not just what they need, all of the above, what they want and what they need, okay? But just find out what they want. And if you give people what they want, and they will want more, Okay, even their need, they want more at any price that you choose. But you need to give them first. You lead with value. Give them what they want. Okay, so find out what the people you want to serve, and find out what they want, and then be the person to provide that. Okay, and whatever it is you're providing that you've packaged together, that's a P. Anything you package together, then we call that the product, right? And that's the second P, right? So you have people, and second step is you create the product that will serve them based on the needs that you find out from the people, okay? And that's the second P right then. That will be your second step in this marketing ideas that I'm sharing with you that can be used on any type of media. So when it comes to marketing, there are three M's, right? And that's kind of identical to the three P's. The three M's is market, message, and media, right? The message is the product, right? The market are the people. Identify the market you want to serve first. So that's the first M, right? Then you create the message that serves their needs, right? That serves their needs, because now you know their needs, you know what they want, and then you're giving it to them in the form of a message, your message for that market, right? Now, how you're going to get that message to the market is what we call media, right? It's called, you know, for example, today in marketing, it's called internet, okay? And I tell you to choose as well to focus on the internet, and everything else should be supporting the internet. Why? Because everybody's on the internet. Hello, right? So now, when it comes to how to get your product to the people, that's the third step, okay? And that's the process, okay? The process of getting your product to the people, you need to identify how you're going to do that. You need to identify your medium, right? Your media, right? So I always tell people, obviously, the internet, okay? They're creating phones. They're creating everything. Everything is connected through this big hub called the internet. So you need to identify that. Now, how do people find these things on the internet? They search, right? The next time you're looking for something, guess where you go? You go on Google. So guess where you need to be? As a market server, as a person that creates products, as a person that creates value into the marketplace, guess where you need to be? You need to be on the internet, right? So the process needs to be leveraging the internet. The process needs to be using the internet to deliver your goodies. And sometimes you have a physical product, but guess who's winning right now? Well, even when it comes to sales of physical product right now, and that's Amazon. So clearly in the internet, and it's using the internet, okay? I mean, there are Amazon fulfillment centers everywhere right now, like warehouses everywhere. And it's gonna get bigger and bigger, right? So that's something I want you to pay attention to. So we just did the first three steps real quick, okay? The first three steps is identify the people, identify the products you want to use to serve their needs and their wants, and then you need to identify the process of getting that product to the people. Those are the three P's. So now when it comes to the process, I'm going to break that down a little bit further right now as to what I call the three C's. So the three C's is going to be your step 4, 5, and 6, okay? And what's three C's? Three C's stands for create, capture, and convert, okay? Create, capture, and convert, okay? And that's the process. And the part where it says capture is how you find, you know, is how you build a list of audience, right? Audience of people. Remember, the first step is identifying the people, but how do you attract more of those people? And that's what we do on the step number 6 over there, step number 5 over there, because 4 is the first C, which is create. What are we creating? We create value for the marketplace, okay? Remember, you're creating a product, but maybe your product is a physical product. So initially, you're creating value in the form of information that you're giving out to the marketplace. Does that make sense? You say, hey, this is what this person needs. I'm giving the information on how to find it, okay? And it can be in the form of answers to questions. It could be in the form of solutions to problems. And it could be just a simple idea of pleasure that replaces the pain that somebody is going through, okay? There's nothing new about what I just said, right? But, oh, wow, yeah, like, that's true, right? Because if you do anything else outside of that, you're going to have a product that doesn't have a market. And that's why a lot of businesses are crashing, because people are busy creating services that people don't want, okay? So in this time and age, I told you earlier, you need to identify the people first before you create a product. See, traditionally, people start creating logos first. People create a website address first. People go register LLCs first. You know, these traditional things don't work. That's why 95% of businesses are going under in their first 5 years, because they do all these traditional things that doesn't make any sense. People start creating a business without making their first sale. It makes no sense, okay? So that's why I just flipped that script for you real quick, okay? It's very simple. Identify your people first. Ask them the question, what would you like me to do for you? How may I help you, right? That's why any calls coming into your business, you should be able to ask that question, how may I help you? If you can't ask that question, you're targeting the wrong market with the wrong information, or you're cold calling somebody, right? And cold calling is working less, and it still works for some people, but I'm telling you right now, you're better off using attraction marketing. And the process I'm sharing with you right now is called attraction marketing, which is the three C's. You create value, you capture the audience, okay? You capture the audience. See, there are two things that you need to pay attention to when it comes to building a business, and that's the audience and influence, okay? I call them the UNCs, right? The audience and influence, right? Your ability to be able to persuade a market to buy from you, right? Without forcing them, without trying to control them. When you can do that, you win the game of life. Not just business, you win the game of life. You have an audience, people chasing after you, people have been attracted to you, but you have the ability to influence them, of course positively, but even if you wanted to, you could do it negatively. Of course, I don't want you to do that, right? I don't want you to use those things in a negative manner, but these things are used by even negative people, right? The ability to influence them positively to do business with you and help them enhance their life and their lifestyle, audience and influence is exactly what I'm sharing with you right now. So back to step number five, capture. You need to capture the audience, the attention, right? You need to build a list. You capture their contact information, okay? How do you do that? You create value. The same thing, you create value, but this time around is a little bit of a higher premium of value. It could be a PDF that's downloadable from a website. It could be an audio that's downloadable. It could be a video. It could be something you could send over to their house. It could be a book, right? And then you give it to them in exchange for free, in exchange for their contact information. Why would they want to do that? Because it's information that they want, remember? It's information that they want. Like, people treat their email addresses like it's a sacred information, right, these days, right? Like a social security number. But not if you're giving them something they want, right? If you're giving them something they truly want, they will say, hey, here's my email address. Not only that, you can say, hey, I want to send the information to your email address, right? So where do you want me to send it? Boom, they give you their email address. You're building a list of email of people that have shown interest in what you have to offer. So that email list, that list building, and that list you're building is the number one true asset that you have in your business. No matter what type of business that you're building, you're not in that business. You are in the media and marketing business. No matter what type of business you build, you are in the business of building a list. You're in the business of people, right? And filling people's needs. You're not in the business of what you create. But never mind, like, a lot of people fail in business again because they're attached to their original idea of what they created. Oh yeah, I have the best product in the world. My product is gonna kill it. My app is gonna kill it. And they forgot to ask the very people they're gonna be selling or offering this product and services to, what do you want? How can I enhance what you have to offer, right? They forget totally. Like, I'm actually guilty too. Like, I have to do a lot more survey of the marketplace to find out what people want. This is a practice, a best practice for any type of business, doing surveys from time to time to find out what people want so you can give them product that they already want, right? And then, boom, it sells very fast, okay? Because they already want the stuff, okay? So you capture the audience, you build that audience, you build a list, and that list that you're building is the number one true asset that you own in any type of business, okay? Because you can turn around these people, you can sell more and more to them. You can say, hey, I have this other product that I think you're going to like. If only 10% of that list is taking you up on the offer, you pay the bills for the month. Okay, and you could run campaigns, you could do promo campaigns to your list and say, hey, this month I'm doing 50% off, would you like to get in? This month I'm doing 25% off. This week I'm doing the Freedom Friday, why don't you come on and take advantage of this 10% for the next 2 hours, and then you pay the bills like that. Okay, then you stay in business for a long time. Okay, does that make sense? So the list is the number one asset. Why do we call it the asset? Because it brings money in, right? So the list of contacts of people that have already said yes, they like to follow what you do, they like to follow your content, they like the idea of what you bring to the marketplace. But not only that, now They love and trust your brand. Remember, people do business with people they know, like, and trust. So they're feeling like they know, like, and trust you, right? So it's a no-brainer for them to do business with you, because people do business with people they feel like they know, like, and trust. They don't have to know, like, and trust you. They just have to feel like they know, like, and trust you. Does that make sense, the difference there, right? And that's how you do that. So you capture people's audience and you continue to serve them. Not just, you continue to serve them, but you offer them something for sale, because if you're not selling anything, then you have no value in the marketplace. Everybody expects to buy something. Everybody comes into the marketplace and expects to buy. So you should never shy away from selling. But the only time you should shy away from selling is if you're not offering free value up front. I tell people I offer free value. I create so much free value that, it's when I tell people to buy from me, it's a normal, it's easy, right? Because they know that I come and I show up every day with free value anyway, okay? And the sixth step is convert. Now, here's the key thing about converts. It's just like the third step, right? Process. And then process is kind of like you don't have to do much. Then I broke it down to the three C's. Now, here's the thing about the third C, which is the sixth step. Is it the sixth step? Yeah, it's the sixth step. You don't have to do much, because a lot of converting to sales is already being done. You're pre-framing all these people's mind all along, because you're giving so much value. See that first C, when you create value in the form of content, videos, articles that answer people's questions, articles and videos that solve people's problems, right? Articles and videos that make people feel good about the pain and replaces with the idea of pleasure their existing pain, right? When you do so much of that, when it's time to ask them for sale, it's effortless. As a matter of fact, they sell themselves on doing business with you. It's effortless. So converting is not something you have to force. You don't have to hard close people. As a matter of fact, these days we don't go by always be closing anymore. We go by always be creating, because if you're creating content and value all the time, if you do that and you out create value, outpace your competition when it comes to creating value, conversion will happen. Closing, people will close themselves on doing business with you. And that's the sixth step in our marketing ideas for any type of business. The seventh step here is multiple streams of income. I can't tell you. MSI, you gotta have that. In this time and age, the only kind of control you have is having multiple streams of income. The example I always give is this. Best Buy does not wait until they sell a TV to make money, okay? If somebody is walking out that door, they can grab water, they can grab an earpiece, earbuds, like they can grab something simple for $1. And that $1 can make the difference between them staying in business within the next 12 months or getting wiped out by the next recession. So you must have cash flow in all areas you can think. No matter what type of business you have, you don't just do what you do to make money from just that. Find out other things you can do on the side, other things you can offer on the side. Yeah, closely related as much as possible, but sometimes it's not related, to be honest with you. Like, for example, selling water at Best Buy, it's not related to TV, but they still sell it anyway, because these are people. People can grab water anytime. Candy, gum, right? At the front desk, like random stuff, like phone cases and stuff like that. Find things like that you can offer in your business that you can offer on a little shelf. If your restaurant, have stuff that people can pick up, those $1, $2, $3, $10 adds up, and that can make the difference between you staying in the business this year and being out of business the next minute, because there's all type of things in market shift. Market does shift, and sometimes it's beyond your control, but this kind of things can keep you in business when you just make sure every money is coming in, okay? So multiple streams of income is a must. Find other related products and services to what you already do and offer them. It could be partnership with other people in your arena, in your business. Find partnerships where you can offer something, and people, when you refer people to them, they refer people back to you. On top of that, they can give you kickback commissions, right? And you can make a lot more cash flow. Cash flow is king in your business, and the way to create cash flow is to have multiple streams of income, and all the money coming in, it adds up, trust me. And you don't want to be feeling macho. You don't want to feel like, hey, I have enough. There's no such thing as enough, because you just never know when the next rainy day is coming. You don't know when the next recession is coming. So it's very important for you to pay attention to that. So that's what I have for you on this particular very core episode of this channel. The seven steps marketing ideas for small businesses, any type of business, honestly. And hopefully you like it. Hopefully you've taken some notes. I would watch this video 10 to 15 times personally. I'll put it in my playlist. I will come back to it every 3 months and watch it if I were you, because this is the very core of how you're going to stay in business beyond 6 years, 7 years, forever, create another business, right? That's how you're going to stay in business, okay? So click share, like this video, okay? Comment below your thoughts and your comments. Subscribe to this channel if you want more videos like this, because I will continue to push out more videos that can help you in your business. I absolutely will continue to do that when it comes to marketing. And my book, make sure you download my book, Empire Lifestyle Secrets, and everything, all the PDFs that come with it. Just click on the link below. And or in the description box, or you could just type in olatux.com/mastermind. That's olatux.com/mastermind, and take advantage of it. Okay. Hopefully you've been enlightened and educated, and I will see you on the next one. Peace.